In this video, we're going to look at factoring algebraic expressions. And the piece of it that we're going to be looking at is common factoring. So between two or more terms, we're going to factor out the greatest common factor that we can. In the last video, when we were doing expanding or multiplying, I instructed you guys to keep the coefficients separate and then group the letters together. So we're going to do a similar approach when we're talking about a common factor. We're going to start by only looking at the coefficients, and then we'll start looking at the letters separately. So starting with the coefficients, we can ask ourselves, what's the greatest common factor between 12 and 18? So let's just do this off to the side for a second. So if we divided by 2, say, we could then get 6 and 9, but then these still share common factors. So then we divide by the 3, and then we get 2 and 3, and those don't share any more common factors. So dividing by 2 and then 3, that means the greatest common factor between these two was equal to 6. Now you might have seen that right away between 12 and 18, but if you don't see it right away, then that's the process you want to look at using. You could also use a prime factorization because 12 is 2 times 6 and then 2 times 3 and 18 is 2 times 9, which is then 3 times 3. And you can see which pieces get shared in common. There's a 2 and a 3 and a 2 and a 3. But then that leftover is a 2 and that leftover is a 3. So in the prime factorization, the greatest common factor is the primes that match up from one number to the next. So that means we're able to pull out a 6. Now, if we look at the letters, the first term has an X, the second term doesn't have an X. The second term has a Y, and the first term doesn't have a Y. So are there any common letters between the two? Any letters that we can take out? No, there aren't, because we don't have an X in both terms and we don't have a Y in both terms. So all we can do in this question for common factoring out is taking out this 6. So what was left from the 12 after we divided out by the 6? It was a 2 and the X just stays there. And what was left with the 18 after we took out the 6? It's going to be 3 and then the Y just stays there. So now this is factored. And we call this factored because we're now writing it as a product. It used to be a sum, and now it's a product, 6 times 2x plus 3y. Let's take a look at another example. So here we have three terms. Again, look at the coefficients first. So between 10, 15, and 25, what's the largest number that you can pull out of there that divides everything? And with those numbers, I would say 5. So to illustrate that, let's factor each of these where they are. And we'll just write it as 2 times 5 a cubed minus 3 times 5 a squared plus 5 times 5 a. So you can see now the 5 is written explicitly and we're about to take that out. And what's left over, 2, 3, and 5, they don't actually share any more common factors. So we're going to take a 5 out and that's the coefficients part. So that's done. So now between the a cubed, a squared, and a, what's the largest power of a that we can take out? It's going to be just a single a. It's going to be equal to the smallest power that you have in every term. So we're going to take out a 5 and an a. So now we write down what's left in each term after we take out, or after we divide out by a 5 and an a. So there's the 2, and then a becomes a squared when you divide by an a. And then now we have the minus 3, and just a single a, and now plus 5. So now that's factored. Again, we've changed it from sum and subtraction to a product. So in this one, we have three terms again, and we'll again start with the coefficients. So between 12, 6, and 18, what's the largest number we can pull out of there? It does look like a 6, because those are all multiples of 6. And now with the x, we've got x to the 7, x to the 5, x to the 3. What's the biggest one we can pull out? Well, the smallest exponent we have common is x cubed, so we'll pull that out. And then y cubed, y squared, and y. The biggest power of y common is just y. So that is our greatest common factor, 6x cubed y, that is common to every single term here. So now we'll open up our brackets, and we'll write what's left of each term after we divide it out by that. So 12 divided by 6 leaves us with a 2. X to the 7, if you divide by x cubed, leaves you with x to the 4. So remember, when you're dealing with coefficients, we're doing 12 divided by 6 is 2. But then when we do with the letters, we're dealing with x to the 7 divided by x to the 3, and that means you just subtract the exponent. So that's a common mistake people make. They'll divide with the coefficients, but then they'll also try and divide with the exponents, or they'll subtract with the exponents, and then they'll subtract with the coefficients as well. So they would have ended up with another 6 there, 12 minus 6. But you have to remember that those are separate. So y cubed divided by y gives me a y squared. In the second term, if we take minus 6 and divide by 6, that's just going to leave us with a minus 1. So I'm just going to write the negative. And then x to the 5 divided by x cubed leaves us with x squared. So we subtract the exponents. Y squared minus y leaves us with 1y. Now plus 18 divided by 6 leaves us with a plus 3. Then x cubed, then we take out the x cubed. And y, we took out the y. So those just go to 1. So this is a shorter way to do a common factoring method. You just have to pay attention as you do to each step, but there's not as much work shown there. If you do need to write the intermediate steps like we did up above, then you can start to factor those out more in pieces as you go. So this last one is a little bit tricky because in each term we have a monomial times a binomial. So this is one term and this is another term. It's just that each of these terms has a product. So one way you could do this is you could factor out right away. The other way to do it is to expand first and then common factor out. So I'm going to do this both ways. So I'm going to draw a line down the middle and I'll expand first. So I'm going to write 14 times 2x plus 14y. And then, so this minus 7, remember, the whole thing has to go together. You have to distribute there. So make sure that the negative changes the signs both times here. So we're going to have minus 7 times 2 times xx, and then minus 7xy. So cleaning things up, we get a 28x plus 14y minus 14 x squared minus 7xy. We don't have any like terms here, so now we'll look at common factoring things out. So we'll start with the coefficients. Between 28, 14, 14, and 7, what is our greatest common factor? Those are all multiples of 7, so let's pull a 7 out. Now let's look at the x's. We've got an x, no x, x squared, and an x. Because there's no x in this term here, we can't actually pull out any x because it's not common to every term. Now let's look at a y. So there's a y almost everywhere except here and here. So for the same reason, we can't pull out anything more than that. So putting our brackets here, 28 divided by 7 leaves us with 4, so 4x, plus 14 divided by 7 is 2, so 2y. Minus 14 divided by 7 leaves us with minus 2, and x squared stays there. And minus 7xy, if we take the minus 7 divided by 7, that's minus 1. So we'll leave it like that. So this is one possible answer that you could get. This is still factored, but you'll see if we do it the other way, where we factored right from the start, you'll actually be able to pull out more. So doing it this way, if we look at 2x plus y, this is actually common in both of these terms already. So you're actually allowed to pull the whole thing out as long as you keep it in its brackets. So 2x plus y is actually a common factor in both terms. So once you take out the 2x plus y, then you've got the 14 and the minus 7x left. So then you can think about, okay, what's the greatest common factor between 14 and minus 7x? So there is probably where you get your 7. So let's just set a set of square brackets now, just to distinguish between the two. So this part here, our 7 and the 2x plus y, is now our greatest common factor. And what's inside the square brackets is what was left. So what's left of 14, 2x plus y, after we divide out by the 2x plus y, and the 7? Just 2. What's left of minus 7x, 2x plus y, if we take out the 2x plus y, and a 7? Then we're going to be left with minus x. So overall, the answer would be 7, 2x plus y, 2 minus x. So I just changed the square brackets back to round brackets, just because now I don't need to distinguish with them anymore. But you could see that if you multiply this back out, you would get back to the original statement. So these two answers are equivalent. However, this one on the right is factored a bit more than the one on the left. So this one is probably a little bit better.